Now, we have a problem in this hall because we were forced to use the PA system that is owned and operated by this place. And personally, folks, I think it eats. And so, but, you know, it's great for My Fair Lady and such as that. But, you know, it's not your regular rock and roll PA system, you know. Just remember that during our program, the bass will never get you here, and the squealing top end will never get you there. But all that stuff in the middle will be completely unintelligible. And therefore, verily I say unto you, the odds that you understood the words of that last song, called A Little More Cheapness, Please, are virtually nil. And that is why we're going to give you an instant rerun on what the text actually was of the song we just played. So George, if you'll take us to the romantic setting of the tiki room at the Holiday Inn. It's sort of like poetry and jazz. I ate a hot dog. It tasted real good. Then I watched a movie from Hollywood. Hey. It tasted real good. And I watched the movie from Hollywood. Just pretend there's a drum fill right in here. And he goes, good God, feet on fire. Yes. Little Miss Muffet on a squat by me. I took a turn around. I said, can you all see the little strings on the giant spider? That is to say, the little strings on the giant spider, the zipper from the Black Lagoon, the vents by the tanks where the bubbles go up, and the flaps on the side of the moon, the jelly in the paint on the 40-watt bulb that they use when the slime drizzles off, the rumples and the wrinkles in the cardboard rock, and the canvas of the cave is too soft. The suits and the hats and the ties too wide and too short for the scientist man. The chemistry lady with the rollaway mind, and of course the monster just ate Japan. Ooh ah! And then I said, ladies and gentlemen, the monster which the peasants in this area call Frenchie, apparently a very large poodle dog, has just been seen approaching the Circle Star Theater. Bullets can't stop it. Rockets can't stop it. We may have to call out the National Guard. And then we go into a frenzy where Napoleon makes up a bunch of words about the poodle has got a long thing that might squirt something on you. And stay away from the poodle. The poodle bites. The poodle does chew it. She knows the poodle bites. How many times has the poodle bitten you? She says the poodle has bitten her this many times. Stand up and testify. The poodle has bitten this in. Is there anybody else in the audience that has been bitten by the poodle? You've been bitten by the poodle. Where did he bite you? Is that the poodle? That is not Frenchie. No, no. Frenchie never had a shirt like that. But if he had, it certainly would have terrified the men from the National Guard, assiduous as they are in their duty. You see, a little bit later in the year, ladies and gentlemen, that song will come out on a record, and in that part, on the record, it has the continuation of what happened with Frenchie, see? Frenchie comes out and he's squirting things all over the countryside and says, you know how poodles do when they get hot? Poodle fanciers unite. Just remember those little pants that you have to put on them sometimes, you know? She knows about the pants. Does he know about the pants? Do you put the pants on together? What a relationship. Ladies and gentlemen, the tragic story of a poodle run amok. Yes, indeed. On the record, it says, here comes that poodle dog, big as a blimp with a rhinestone collar, snapping off the trees just like they was bonsai ornaments on a dry wobble landscape. Keep it away. Don't let the poodle bite me. We can't let it reproduce. Keep it away. And then I come in and I say, my own dramatic style, I say, the National Guard is lined up at the base of the mountain where they expect to lure the unsuspecting poodle out of the cave so they can destroy it with napalm. a thousand of the troopers are lined up at the base of the mountain, and they're all going, "Here, Fido! Here, Fido!" Then it goes into the next verse, when it says, "Well, follow me, go to the shelter, follow me, go to the shelter, my baby, go to the shelter." And if you've ever seen a Japanese horror movie, you know that is exactly the text of the sound effects loop that they use during all the disaster scenes. Then it says, "Little Miss Muffet on a squat by me, can you see the little legs dangling down? No, little strings dangling down. It makes the legs go wobble and the jaw flap shut. And the horrible eye go rolling, rolling, yes indeed, rolling around." And then there's a little play your marimba like Ruth. And he says, "Yes indeed, very smooth. Can you see it at all? Can you see it from here? Can you laugh till you're weak on your knees? Well, if you can't, I'm sorry, baby. That's all I want to know, because I need a little more cheapness, please. Yes, indeed. A little more cheapness, please. A little more cheapness, please. A little more cheapness, please." And George, in between all those lines, George is saying, "Nappy is a booger booger. Chester is a booger booger. Tom is a booger booger. Ruth is a booger booger." He might have said Frank was a booger booger in there too, but I couldn't hear him. And then it goes, "Ha ha," and that's the end of the song.